Award-winning chef Jock Zonfrillo is being remembered as someone with a passion and love for food following his sudden death. Today, Melbourne reporter Isabella Stafskowski joins us with more. Isa, the loss is being felt heavily by many people this morning.
It certainly is, Carl. Good morning again to you. His family say he was an irreplaceable husband, father, brother, son and friend. This loss is really being felt right around the world. He was a celebrated chef of international acclaim, and here in Melbourne, the very tight-knit chefing community is certainly feeling that very deeply. Those tributes are continuing this morning here from Gordon Ramsay, saying, saddened by the devastating news of Jock Zonfrillo's passing. I truly enjoyed the time we spent together on MasterChef in Australia, sending all my love to Lauren and the family in this difficult time. Julie Goodwin tweeting, heartbroken and lost for words. This is unfathomable. My love to Jock's family and to all the MasterChef family. He was so kind to me. He, of course, leaves behind a very loving partner and four beautiful children. We do know that this latest season of MasterChef, it had wrapped filming. It was due to premiere last night. It's being paused this week, of course, out of respect to Jock and his family. Carl, it is unclear when, if or how that will finally go to air.
Isa, thank you.
Well, the sudden passing of celebrity chef Jock Zonfrillo has sent shockwaves through the industry as many of his celebrity friends and colleagues take to social media to honour his life and legacy. We're joined by one of his good friends now, celebrity pastry chef Darren Purchase in Melbourne. Darren, thanks so much for your time. This was truly heartbreaking news when we heard about it yesterday. How are you holding up?
Yeah, good morning, Sarah. Yeah, it's still such a shock, really, still. You know, it's been less than 24 hours and it's hard to come to terms with. Waking up this morning certainly wasn't any easier. And I just know that I personally am devastated, and I know that there's been a huge hole left in the hospitality industry, not just in Melbourne, but in fact across the entire world.
I mean, he had such an incredible presence that was really felt by anyone who surrounded him. We know that he, of course, did have some challenges in his life, which he was very open about. Can you speak to the kind of person he was, the person who you knew?
Yeah, he was an absolute diamond. I loved him. He was awesome. He was supportive. He was compassionate. He was very generous. He was always worrying about other people above himself. Obviously, he had charm and charisma. He was perfect for the role that he was in on our TV screens. But in the kitchen, he was just an absolute giant, a great chef, someone that we all looked up to in the hospitality industry, and just a really great person. Often he would reach out to me and just, you know, pick up the phone and check that I'm doing okay. And he's always there and very supportive. So it's just a massive loss.
I remember being out to dinner with Jock and he would study the menu like nothing else. He had such a passion for food, didn't he? And for his family, of course, and bringing people along on that culinary journey. He did have an impact.
Yeah, huge. And he loved his food, you're right. The number one, you know, he absolutely loved cooking. It was the thing he loved the most in the world. So you could talk to him about food all the time. Mm. And, of course, you know, bringing food and family together was really his thing. And, you know, he was great company. And I'm sending all of my love out to his family at this horrible time.
Yeah, as are we. Lots of love to Lauren, Ava and the kids. Thank you, Darren.